Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you the basics of using System Preferences on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So System Preferences is how you control settings on your Mac. You can get to it a number of different ways. By default, you should see System Preferences in your dock. But it's always available in the Apple menu and you just select System Preferences. System Preferences shows you categories of preferences by icon. So you can see icons like General, Desktop and Screensaver, and Dock and Menu Bar. The icons are arranged in three different groups with third-party System Preferences at the bottom. At the top though you should see your name and information that applies to you as the user of this Mac account. You also see the very important Apple ID System Preferences here. You click that and it will take you to preferences that have to do with your Apple ID, iCloud, and other Apple services. Whenever you're looking at a category of preferences, you can always click on this button here to go back to the main System Preferences screen. There are other ways to view the System Preferences. In the View menu, you can change from Organized by Categories to Organized alphabetically. Notice under View, you also have a list of all of the different categories here. So you can simply jump to one by selecting it from this list. If you want, you can even customize what you see. So in View Customize, you now get checkboxes next to everything. And if you want to hide something, you can uncheck it and now click Done and you can see that's gone. But it's still available here. Another thing you could do is search, but you can search for more than just the name of the individual system preference. For instance, in General here is a setting for the default web browser. Now if you forget where that is, you can simply search for it. And you can see it comes up here as a result and it shows you where it's located. You can click here or here then to get to it. So once you're inside one of the categories, also called a pane, as in a window pane, you can change your preferences using a variety of different things. For instance, here's a checkbox for allowing wallpaper tinting in Windows. For show scroll bars, there are three radio buttons. A radio button is basically like a checkbox, but it's a series of them and only one can be selected at a time. Sometimes there are drop-down menus, like for default web browser, I can choose one of the installed browsers from this menu. Other times there are custom controls, like for appearance, I can go to light, dark, or automatic, and you can see it kind of works like a radio button, but it has a custom picture instead of a little circle. In some of these, the controls get even more complex. In Dock and Menu Bar, you have a sidebar here on the left. So if you want to control things that have to do with the Dock and Menu Bar, you have this selected and you can see various controls here. Here you see some sliders for size and magnification. If I wanted to look at Control Center settings, I click on one of these items in the sidebar and I would just go through each one of these for various different settings. Desktop and Screensaver has another complex set of controls. There's a whole list here of pictures that you can scroll through and set one as your desktop background. But this is also a drag and drop area, so you can drag and drop a photo into here. At the top here you can actually see there are two different tabs for this System Preferences pane. The Desktop tab and the Screensaver tab. So it changes what's underneath here. So it's kind of a deeper level. You can see the same thing say in Spotlight where there's search results and privacy. For security and privacy, there's a whole set at the top. General, File Vault, Firewall, and Privacy. So as you can see, you can go pretty deep into System Preferences. There's a lot more than what you see just here at the top level. Now one way System Preferences is fundamentally different from the Settings app in iOS is that you will not find app settings there. Instead, you'll find those in the individual apps. So here I am in Mail, for instance, and I can go to Mail Preferences. And this is where I get to preferences that have to do with this app. The same thing with Safari. I go to Safari Preferences in the Safari app. I won't find Safari settings in System Preferences. There are a couple other ways to access System Preferences. One is by using one of the menu bar icons at the top. Sometimes those have direct access to the preferences. For instance, here's the Bluetooth icon and you could see I could select that and go to Bluetooth Preferences. It opens up System Preferences right to Bluetooth. And if you have System Preferences in the dock, you can click and hold on it and an alphabetical list of System Preferences will pop up and you can select one right from that list and it will jump right to it. If you're a power user, one of the things you want to do occasionally is go through System Preferences and look in every single category. Go through each item here. If you don't know what it is, maybe try it out. Or use the little question mark icon at the bottom to bring up help so you can read about what each thing is. This is how you discover new functionality on your Mac or ways that you can customize it that you didn't know existed before. A lot of times I'm asked how I know everything that I know about Macs. And this is one of my tricks, is to simply explore, go through all of System Preferences, look and see what's new. I do that every time Apple comes out with their annual major update of macOS. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.